Hello, I'm Sunil Kamath, Principal Director of Program Management, responsible for Azure Open Source Databases, and also serve in the Azure Data Leadership Team. And today I'm extremely proud and excited and honored at the same time to deliver this talk on open source and Azure data, now and next. I'm leading with the heart because of how important open source is to me, and recording this from the comfort of my own house. Imagine most of you have your own personal journeys with open source. Let me share a bit of mine. My journey with open source started back in Toronto, Canada in the early 2000s at IBM as a performance engineer. Worked a lot with Linux and databases. If you may recall, in the early 2000s, while Linux popularity was growing as a desktop operating system, it was not a great operating system to run databases. There was a lot of work that was needed to improve memory management, scheduler algorithms, file I/O management, etc. I had a distinct privilege to drive several improvements and optimizations. Look at the progress of where Linux is today. There's not an app that does not run on Linux, and for that matter, does not run efficiently and scale. Fast forward to into Microsoft, just over 3 years ago, I helped launch two of the most popular open source relational databases in the industry on the Azure platform, MySQL and Postgres. MySQL and Postgres were the most sought after databases from our customers. We listened and delivered. Can you spot me in this picture? Gosh, look at how close I'm sitting to my teammates in this picture. Seems surreal. Obviously wouldn't have happened today for obvious reasons due to COVID-19. In the same time frame, May of 2017, authored this post of preview of Azure Postgres database service. Truly, truly exciting days. Love my work on open source databases, as I'm sure you can see it then and now. Just less than 1 year later, in 2018, here I am being interviewed on Microsoft Mechanics, talking about the general availability of open source databases on Azure. The same year, we also brought Azure Database for MariaDB to the platform. Since the availability of these services, it has been extremely popular on Azure. A big, big thank you to all of those, to all those who have made this service to what it is today. We couldn't have done without your support and feedback. The great apps and solutions developed using these databases led us down the path to do more, the acquisition of Citus Data. I was intimately involved in this acquisition of Citus Data into Microsoft. For those that are not familiar, Citus is an open source extension to Postgres that transforms single node Postgres and transforms it into a horizontally scalable distributed Postgres. And Postgres itself, as you all know, is a very popular open source relational database. I will talk more about Citus a bit later. This is obviously not going to be a talk about me, my resume, or just my work or my team's work. I'm here today representing all of Azure Data and my colleagues here within Azure Data that is obsessed about their work, about solving your challenges and delivering solutions on your terms. I'm here today to talk about what our team in Azure Data is doing for the open source community. What our Azure Data team is doing for data professionals. What are we doing for developers? Allow me to talk about our mission. Our mission at Azure Data, delivering the one database platform, one data platform that empowers the world to make sense of all data anywhere, any scale. We derive our inspiration and purpose from this very mission statement to serve you, our customers and partners. This mission, by the way, is not possible without open source. Open source is a very key ingredient. Within Azure Data, we now have comprehensive open source based data products ranging from relational databases to Hadoop, Spark, etc. Literally every product or service we use has some open source technology in it. We contribute to open source. We integrate with open source. If you are a developer or an architect that primarily prefers to use Azure, to use open source, you have all of these capabilities and this rich ecosystem seamlessly integrated within Azure. It has never been a more empowering time to work with data. Whether you are a data scientist or a developer or a manager, a marketer, or anyone making decisions based on data, because due to COVID-19, things are different. I want to share a few examples. How my team at Azure Data, alongside with our partners, is helping to make an impact. First example, this is a super interesting story and recently published. Microsoft Healthcare Bot. You can find a URL on this slide to make it easy for you to learn to look things up later. This article is about how Healthcare Bot is being used to fight the good fight against COVID. This healthcare bot helps to screen people for possible coronavirus infections and treatments. Used in 23 countries and also in European countries like Denmark, Italy, Finland. And just from the beginning of March 2020 through the middle of May, this has served over 320 million messages, helped over 31 million individuals built on top of Azure. Specifically, the Azure Redis Cache, Azure Cosmos Database, our flagship NoSQL database, Azure Search, etc. A critical sector impacted due to COVID-related stay-at-home order has been education. With many, many schools and universities across the world being shut down, I've been deeply touched and impressed by how local governments and private institutions have stepped up to this challenge. As an example, in Asia, live lecture wasn't working and students were not able to access lectures. They needed to make home-based learning work. In just a few weeks, we enabled a solution that serves over 4 million students on Azure and using our MySQL service from inception to production. And this example is just the beginning. If this was a previous generation of data center architecture or software architecture, I don't think we would have been able to deal with this crisis as effectively as we have been able to. We've also been working very closely with partners to support local government initiatives. Our Azure database services are an integral part of the solution to respond to COVID-19, enabling emergency response services, things like coordinating donations of essential supplies. We also made it possible for volunteers to register, offer their services so that doctors, nurses, paramedics, IT professionals could register to help people who needed help. Azure database services are also part of an effort here in Europe as governments approved funding loans aimed at financing working capital for small businesses, and especially those in sectors which are significantly impacted due to COVID. One of the banks found their application requiring to scale to 2 million connections. The inherent scale available in our data services, in this case MySQL, helped to support this increased load with full security and, most importantly, cost effectively. And then there is this working from home thing, which I suspect has touched many of you, especially those of us who work in software where nature of our jobs allow us to do it from home. And we are pretty lucky that way. Although I have to say, I know that working from home is a privilege, but I also have two small kids at home. And I know firsthand it's not that easy. My admiration and empathy for all of you out there who are doing your best to meet everybody's demand, be it kids, family, work, teammates, under these testing times. Another example of how things are different. At Microsoft, we've seen a huge spike in the usage of Microsoft Teams. As of mid-May, we have over 75 million daily active users, over 4 billion meeting minutes per day. Privilege, truly a privilege to help people around the world to enable to work remotely in a more secure way. Staying connected through video meetings, calls, chats, etc. I spend a good part of my days in meetings, conference calls, collaborating with my team. And for those who have internet bandwidth, it helps to see people, not just to hear their voice, but to actually see their expressions, their reactions, to stay connected. It's a privilege to be able to do what I do, and I'm hugely grateful for that. I should point out that Microsoft Teams runs on Azure. Teams is a fully cloud-native application. The fact that Teams is able to handle this volume in these testing times is a testament for what Azure and cloud can provide to these critical applications. And we are building all of this, Azure's cloud infrastructure, in a very sustainable way. Now back to the heart I started this talk with. At Microsoft, we love open source. You could say perhaps more correctly that we have grown to love open source. And my team, well, we live, eat, breathe open source, making our open source cloud databases easy to provision, more accessible, more secure, easy to deploy in the cloud. Which takes me to the quote from Satya, our CEO. There's something about this quote from Satya that I find really compelling. Drives home that Microsoft today is not the company we were 10 years ago. Satya says, judge us by the actions we have taken in the recent past, our actions today, and in the future. The fact is that companies and culture and people can change. And I feel blessed to be part of this change at Microsoft. Today at this European Open Source Summit, I believe three of my teammates are going to be giving a talk. John Gossman, Jose Miguel, and Tony Milberg. On the state of Linux on Azure, there is so much going on with Linux and open source on Microsoft Azure. This is just one example of our commitment to open source, and there are much, much more. I mentioned the Citus Data acquisition earlier. I was involved in this acquisition from the very beginning. Getting to know the team, the founders, and their wholehearted commitment to the Postgres open source community. So Citus is an extension to Postgres, as I just talked about before. It transforms Postgres into a horizontally scalable distributed database, which means it's possible to do things that simply were not possible before. Citus is open source, as I just talked about, and I'm very happy to say also available as a built-in cloud-native, fully integrated deployment option for our Postgres database offering on Azure. It is Postgres Hyperscale. I put a short URL on the screen to the GitHub repo for the Citus open source project, in case any of you want to try it out or learn more. I talked about how scaling out Postgres with Citus opens the door to new possibilities. I love this quote from our own internal user who uses Postgres and Citus running on Azure to power an analytical dashboard. It is used by the Windows Data and Intelligence team. Captures over 20,000 different types of metrics from over 800 million devices, supporting hundreds of concurrent users. Over 6 million queries executed every day. It's a huge deployment, making it possible to make shiproom decisions for Windows. I put a short URL to this blog post that dives with much more detail about this workload, the use case, and their implementation details, in case any of you want to read and learn more about this story. But I don't want you to think we just build great capabilities on top of open source and use open source only for our own benefit. We believe it's super important to contribute back to open source communities in very meaningful ways. Which leads to, just a few months ago, we welcomed three Postgres committers to our Postgres team at Microsoft. Committers in Postgres are engineers who have made substantial contributions to Postgres and who lead key areas of ongoing Postgres development and innovation. And that's what Thomas Munro, Jeff Davis, and Andrew Sfrin are continuing to do so. Collaborating and partnering with developers around the world from multitude of other companies to shape the future of Postgres. In fact, since this blog was initially published, a new Postgres committer has joined Microsoft. So we went ahead and photoshopped David Raleigh into this picture, since obviously his work is also very important and I didn't want to leave him out of this story. Our open source contribution also expands into other areas such as Azure Data Studio, as an example, which is a multi-database cross-platform tool that is very popular, supports SQL Server and Postgres today, and plans to expand it to support other databases as well. One more example to share. This picture is from a video filmed in Florida in November of 2019 as part of our Microsoft Ignite event. David Schneider is the Vice President of Engineering at Systems Imagination. He got up on the stage to demo what his company is doing with SQL database and big data clusters on Azure in their fight against cancer, in their effort to analyze what is called synthetic lethality. SQL Server Big Data Clusters allow you to deploy scalable clusters of SQL Server Spark HDFS containers running on Kubernetes. These components are running side by side to enable you to read, write, process big data from either T-SQL or Spark, allowing you to easily combine and analyze your high-value relational data with high-volume big data. The team at Systems Imagination use Spark, SQL Database, Azure Data Studio, Big Data Clusters, amongst others, in a way that was dramatically faster and less expensive than doing it on-premises. I haven't talked much about products today. Strange for me, I'm a product guy. I do want to mention that earlier in May, Microsoft Build, our annual developer event, went online too. All digital for 48 hours with tons and tons of content for all of you now to consume. Just go to mybuild.microsoft.com and click on the Watch on Demand Sessions button. You can learn more about a ton of new capabilities we announced, which are all Azure Data related at this event. Of course, some of those will be also covered as part of this open source summit. And now it's time to wrap up this keynote and let you move on to what's next. I hope that all of you and your families, first of all, stay safe and healthy. I also hope that you can find the silver lining in this mess, this chaos that is COVID. Know that our team in Azure Data is working extremely hard to support all of our users, customers, and partners, and committed to contributing and keep giving back to open source communities wherever we can. And also importantly, know that we love your feedback. We have this thing called user voice. So for most Azure services, you can search and get to user voice page for the service. Feedback is a gift. We value it, we treasure it, we thank you for it. Speaking of thank yous, big thank you to all of the speakers who have worked tirelessly hard in order to make all of this useful content available to you today. Our gratitude to all the teams participating in this event. And a huge shout out to the organizers who made all of these things happen. And thanks to all of you for joining us today.